Hi, this is John. Welcome to another lesson of Great Idea English by Caucus Maroc. So, today I just want to discuss a little bit of the differences between the TOEFL and the IELTS test. Right now, a lot of students who are going overseas to study at university, maybe in Europe, in America, in China, in Germany, a lot of the universities will ask for one of these tests. So students, a lot of time, they have a choice. Should I take the TOEFL or should I take the IELTS test? Well, in this video, I just want to go over what are some of the main differences between these two tests, and that will hopefully allow you to choose the test that's going to be right for you. Right? So to start with, the TOEFL is an American test. So that means that you're going to hear American accents. Now, if you watch a lot of Hollywood films and listen to a lot of English music, you're probably more comfortable listening to the American accent, right? Whereas the IELTS test is British, and that means that it has a whole range of accents. You might find Scottish accents, Irish accents, English accents, Australian accent, New Zealand, South Africa, Canada, perhaps, much more diverse range of accents that you will find on the IELTS test on the listening section. So if you are unfamiliar with British sounding English, it's going to be a little bit more difficult coming to the IELTS test than if you are familiar with American English. The next point I like to make is that the TOEFL test is 100% academic. What does that mean? It's designed for students who want to study at American universities. So that means that all the topics covered, the conversations, the listening, is all based on life at university. Even if it's not specifically an academic lecture that you're listening to, by the way, there are a ton of those on the TOEFL test, you will still have the context of being at a university. If it's students talking, if it's students talking to an administrator or a professor, you are still going to be on the campus of a university simulation on this test. Now, the IELTS is academic. It has a lot of academic aspects to it, especially the academic IELTS test, but also has some social aspects as well. On the listening section, you find many topics and interactions that are not necessarily tied to academia or the university. You might find something about job training. You have people having easy question answers about, for example, shipping packages. So there are more social and everyday interactions and material that you're going to find on the IELTS test. Now, the TOEFL test, if you watched my other video about the TOEFL test, is that it's very, very standard. That means that it does not deviate, it does not change from the way that it is set up. You know what kind of questions are coming, you know what kind of interactions you're going to be listening to during the test, and that can really help you prepare for it, right? Whereas the IELTS test has much more diverse material. Because it's not purely academic, you can find, like I said, a lot of everyday situations and things that can come out at you. Now, of course, the everyday world is a much more diverse place than university. So that means that there's going to be more topics that could potentially emerge on the IELTS test that you might not be familiar with, that can be challenging. On to the last point, which is the big one, is that the TOEFL is a computer-based test, right? Now, a couple things there to keep in mind. On the speaking section, you are going to be speaking into a computer, into a microphone. A lot of people might find that difficult. Most of the time when we speak, it's with somebody. Maybe it's our teacher, it's our friend, it's our classmate, it's our neighbor. It's a social interaction. And language is kind of tied to that social interaction, which is very difficult on a TOEFL test when you have to create your language, but you are just talking into a machine. Furthermore, on the computer-based TOEFL, you must use an American-style keyboard. Now, if you're from here or Europe or someplace, you use a French-style keyboard, right? And that means that as the clock is ticking and you have only 5 or 10 minutes left to write your essay, you need to know where the keys are. If you can type effectively and quickly, and it is an art, it is a skill they used to teach people in school, that's going to help you so much on this test. If you're used to American keyboards, fantastic, it's not going to be a huge problem. However, if you're not, that's going to be a really big detriment to you scoring as highly as you can on the written aspect of the TOEFL test. Now, on the IELTS test, it's paper-based and it's person-based. So, what does that mean? That means that when you're writing the essay, it's going to be with your hand. It's going to be in your handwriting, which is probably going to be easier for you, although not the person who's marking it, right? Also, on the speaking section, you're actually talking to a person. It's a person who's asking you questions and you are responding to those. Now, the organic nature of this social interaction will probably make it easier on the speaking test in terms of the IELTS, but I'll let you decide. If it's easier talking to a computer, fantastic. If it's easier talking to a person, okay. Everybody's different. So here are just some of the main differences between a TOEFL and the IELTS test. If you're thinking about taking one of them, keep in mind the differences. If you know somebody who is taking or thinking about taking one of these tests, go ahead and share with them this video. And if you are interested in reviewing for either of these tests with us at Great Idea English here in Rabat, please get in touch and we'd be happy to help you prepare to maximize your score on the IELTS or the TOEFL test, whichever one you choose. Thank you so much. Train hard, fight easy. Have a nice day.